Sorry, give me. Hello?
I think we're all here.
I am. It won't let me share the camera. It said the host has stopped it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. But if you look at the top, we're all here.
Greetings.
Hey, Mike. Is Maribel coming in under Alyssa's?
I would think so.
Yes, I'm here.
Hi, Maribel. How are you?
Hi, good. How are you?
Good.
So Corporation Council, I believe, is coming?
Yes.
Okay. And this is going to be just a voice, not a video. Is that correct? Or
I'm not sure. I don't know why you guys can't.
It says the host. I don't know who the host is. That you?
Yeah, that's me. We're using a new website, so
yeah. It says the video. You can't start your video because the host has stopped it. And I don't know how much that matters, but or if it's supposed to be videoed.
That's weird.
Do you see our names, and is there something that you can?
Yeah, that's what I'm trying to figure out, if I could turn your video on, but I think you guys could do that. But I'm going to call IT and hopefully they're still here because I'm in the office, so.
Okay, it says that the host has stopped it, so I don't know what that means.
Yeah, I have no idea.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, we got a few minutes, hopefully, for Barbara to come from Corporation Council, too.
Yes. All right. Just give me 1 second. I'm going to call IT.
Okay. I mean, I don't know that we need it. Do we?
I don't think we need it.
Yeah. I just don't know if with the new webinar practice, if it needs to be videoed. Hmm. Hello, Barbara.
Hi, I'm sorry. I'm having some technical difficulties. It looks like my video is stopped, but I'm here. Right.
And Maribel is looking at that because I don't know if it has to be videoed or just voice recorded, but she's checking with IT because all of us have that.
Oh, okay. All right. Well, then I'm in good company.
Yeah, you're not alone.
And I just want to check, Barbara, Sarah, can you hear us? You're on mute, but can you? I see Barbara, Sarah up there, but I haven't heard her yet. And it looks like she tried to call me about 20 minutes ago. So I don't know if she's having technical difficulties or not. I'm going to give her a call.
I'm here.
Oh, you're there. Okay. All right.
All right. Good.
All the players are here. We'll just wait and see if we get videoed or not.
Could you tell us who the players are, please?
On your screen, it should say it also up at the top or on the bottom, depending. It's Barbara Sarah, Mike. It says Mike Decker,
yep.
Charlotte Adamus, Barbara Sarah, and then 9 participants.
Oh. I see Barbara Graves Poehler. She's the attorney.
She's our corporation counsel, yes. And she's here. As part of our panel. So there's 6 of us as a panelist. You, that's Barbara Sarah, Mike Decker, Charlotte Adamus, Barbara Graves Poehler, Maribel, who's coming up as Elisa Tinte, because she's using the clerk's office, and myself.
So So I believe that you guys are able to share your video now. I said that I allowed you guys. So could you guys see if
there
you guys?
Go.
Sweet.
Not me. You didn't want me?
It just says allow all panelists to start video. So maybe you could try again.
I am trying, yeah. Says you can't start because the host.
I just sent your request.
Okay. There it is.
There you go. In all your glory.
Is that what it is? Glory? Well, I'll take it. All right, so since we're all here, it's 4:37 and call the order to order the meeting of the Ethics Board on at 4:37 on Thursday, January 27th. I received a couple of questions about the rules and regulations and the complaint forms. And I want to say that they're available on the city website for anybody to view or, you know, to download and print out and, you know, to complete a complaint form and submit it. And they are, I believe, they are submitted to the city clerk's office where they'll be recorded and then sent to us.
In what form are they sent to us?
We would get an email notifying us of the complaint and the complaint.
Okay. Thank you.
Yep. And then we would set a date to meet and discuss it.
I had a question. Procedural, which is interesting because I, you know, looking at the, I think Mike had shared a copy, a link to the address form, and can they be sent in anonymously or must they legally have a signature?
We have had anonymous complaints.
That's why I'm asking. And just, you know, not having seen the raw form before.
Yeah. We have had anonymous complaints. There's an additional difficulty in following up on them. You can't contact the complainant. You don't know who they are. So whatever's in the complaint is what you have. And, you know, we still look into them and see what we can see, what's there, what's not there, you know. And again, reminder that our goal is to be helpful and educational.
Sure. Yeah. Just wondered because it doesn't have a play, like there's nothing on the form that says may be submitted anonymously.
Right.
So just wondering if like there's a legal issue with that when somebody doesn't sign.
We can talk about this more in attorney-client session, but I just want to note two things. The form has been available on the website for some time. It does not expressly direct submission to the clerk, but that's certainly, you know, something people have done, and then the clerk routes it directly to the chair. And then the form on the website asks several questions, including, you know, the identity, contact information of the complainant, but also have you previously filed a complaint concerning this matter with the Ethics Board, city, town, county agency, or other office? So I don't know if that answers your question or maybe obscures the answer to your question, Charlotte, but that's what the form says.
Okay. Yeah, no, I was simply, Barbara, just wondering, you know, because it does have all of that, you know, your contact information, et cetera. If somebody submits that to us anonymously, is it required? It doesn't say required or not required. Just wondering if that should be made more clear on the form. That's all, including where it needs to be sent would be a good idea.
Yeah, the assumption of the clerk, the assumption is that it goes to the clerk's office. But if it isn't written, I don't know that that's a safe assumption.
Right.
And maybe we want to find a way to standardize it, you know. I don't know. But Barbara would know how to do that.
You got two Barbaras there, so one of us will figure it out.
Yeah.
I'm signing everything now with an S after my name.
Barbara S. There you go. Okay. So, yeah, we can talk and an attorney client and go over those.
Okay.
The details of how it should be, you know, is the way that they've been recorded, is that the best way?
Yeah. Again, just thinking about being educational, being transparent, being easy. You know, we want people to get to the right place, do the right thing from the start.
Right.
So.
Okay. Right. Well, Doug. The disclosures are not due yet, and everyone has until February 15th to get them in. If they need to have them notarized, is there someone at the city that could notarize the forms?
We have multiple notaries. Janet here in my office is a notary, I think. Both Dee and Sue, but I could be wrong about that. Over in the clerk's office are probably notaries.
Okay.
I think for now it's just Janet. That's who we refer people to. Yeah.
Okay. Poor Janet. Well, I don't know how many there are, but yeah, notaries are important. And most banks have a notary. I think they all do that. That are usually free for their customers to use.
Ulster Savings definitely has one uptown if you're an Ulster Savings.
Ulster Bank. Federal, Med Hudson, they all, I think they all have them.
Yeah. And UPS. But if you're going into town hall anyway.
Right. Yeah. No, but there are options that people can use. It doesn't have to be one place. And if they don't have a place, they can access City Hall and have it done.
So what are we waiting for?
We are waiting to do what we do. So the disclosures will be in by February 15th. Some will be on desk somewhere, just, you know, on the way in or whatever. So we usually meet in March. I have penciled in March 2nd or 3rd. I don't know what works for everyone.
I'll be away all of February, but I'll be back in March.
Okay. And the logistics of this, we'll need to have a room. And two people need to review each disclosure form.
Mm-hmm.
And sign off on it.
Are they coming in? Do you know?
Oh, we won't know till the day we go there, where they're at. Okay. And then we'll determine who hasn't, and then we'll notify them or we'll ask to have them notified that they need to. So some of the things that have occurred is the annual letter, the report to the mayor, was delivered on, I believe, January 12th before the January 15th, and a copy was sent to the clerk's office. I reviewed the letter when I delivered it to the mayor's office. And Charlotte, I had added, that when we submitted the suggestion to review and revise, that we resubmitted a version with this version of the board.
Mm-hmm.
And that we presented it to a part of the Common Council.
Okay.
And hopefully we'll hear back on, you know, what they're doing with it or plan to do with it.
Okay.
or if they just want to leave it as is. So in talking of complaints, one of the questions is, are there any new complaints? And my understanding is there are not. Mirabelle, do you have any update on that? Was there any brought in today?
Yeah, no new complaints.
Great. That's a beautiful thing. Thanks. All right. So I would think, is there any new business that people need to bring up, or any old outlying business? And if not, then maybe there could be a motion. We do have a complaint to review, the 12/27/2020-9 complaint, which is involving either employees or officials of the city, and regarding specific individuals and allegations, and that would need to be conducted in a executive session. But we would need motions and seconds and votes and all of that.
I make a motion. We enter executive session to discuss 12/27/2021-9.
I second the motion.
All right. All in favor? Aye.
Aye. Aye.
So that's Barbara. Sarah is an aye. Is a yes. Yeah. Paul, it's a yes. Michael's a yes. And I'm a yes. So we will pause the public version of this. We'll go into executive session and discuss the pending case. And when we're completed there, we'll vote our way out of the executive session back into public session. Okay. And does everyone have the number to call?
Yes.
So please make sure that you mute and you turn off your video.
Yeah, don't sign out, Barbara Sarah, okay?
Yeah, I know.
Okay.
A little extra advice.
Excellent.
All right, give it a go, Barbara. Let's see if you can.
Alan, did you send the notice?
Yes. Did you get it?
I don't think so. When did you send it? Never mind. Got it. Found it.
You got it?
Thanks.
Okay. Got it. Barbara Sarah, where are you?
Are you talking about making the phone?
Yes, you got that right. So you've muted yourself. Can you do your camera, or did you? Yes, you did. All right, see you there.
Alan, you're not muted.
Alan, Barbara, Sarah, we're just wondering where you are on the call.
Charlotte, should I send the...
I just got, Barbara was calling me. So I just walked you through how to get to the executive session.
Okay.
I'll go there now.
Okay, great. Thanks.
Yep. Well, hi there.
I'm into the light.
Oh, no. Oh, it's dark.
When we started this, it was light out there.
Yeah, no. I planned on them going quickly, but they often do not. So who's here?
I think the gang's all here.
Well, we're, I don't know if Maribel's back here yet.
Yep, I'm here.
All right.
Hello.
So, we are back from the executive session to discuss the complaint that we had identified earlier. And the Ethics Board has discussed and voted on complaint number 12-27-2020-9 and come to a resolution. The complainant and the subject of the complaint will be notified of the decision. I don't know if we have other business to discuss. Are other members of the board here? I'm not seeing anybody.
Yes, we are.
Yeah, we're here.
Okay, good.
Just set the meeting date for the next meeting.
Yeah, and I'm looking at some availabilities, and there are some. I was thinking the second, which is a Wednesday, or the third, and it would be an on-site meeting at City Hall, and I would assume in one of the conference rooms to review this, to open the public meeting and then review the disclosures.
March 9th, is that what you're talking
about? Second or third.
That's what I do into the 15th of February, right?
February, right. So this would be two and a half weeks later.
I would like to suggest that we go closer to the middle of March. My concern is that the Omicron numbers are still going up, and I just am hesitant to set an in-person meeting, and I know we need to meet in person, but
yeah, I won't. I'll be out of the area from probably the 15th on. But I thought the numbers were going down. That's what I'm
asking. Who do you ask? That's how you find out.
Yeah, TV.
My friend works in the Kingston Hospital, and he said it's pretty bad right now. He's a physician. Well,
how about the 9th?
How about it?
Okay, let's try for it.
All right.
What time?
Well, is 4 o'clock a time that people could be there?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. Maribel?
Yes.
Could you have us scheduled for an area that we can work on and review? We'll have a meeting on the 9th at 4 o'clock. It'll be in person to review the disclosure forms. Mm-hmm. No, we'll open a regular meeting, and then we have to go in and review the disclosure forms.
Is this the 9th of February or March?
March.
Okay. You'll just have to send Elisa an email as well, just with your agenda and just telling her of the meeting as well.
Nope. If telling you doesn't accomplish that, okay.
She likes it in written form, so yeah.
Okay. We will do so. Are there any other areas or items on the agenda that anyone needs to speak of? That I see Charlotte's a no.
I'm good.
Michael?
I'm set.
Barbara?
Yeah, I just wanted to thank you all for making this meeting earlier than you had originally wanted, because I have a board meeting at 6:30 and I was able to stay for this whole meeting.
Great.
Thank you.
All right. And thank you, Barbara Poehler. We appreciate your support and presence. And so is there a motion to, if there's no further business, is there a motion to adjourn?
I'll make a motion to adjourn.
Second. All right. I hear you, Barbara, Sarah, and Michael.
Yeah, he did.
Correct.
Okay. And me too. So we're all in favor and approving the adjournment. And the adjournment is taking place at 6:01. You all have a good night.
Bye.
Be careful.
A lot to think about. It's really wonderful. Thank you.
Thanks.